Achilles pain. You might be watching this because you have been diagnosed with an Achilles tendonitis, tendinopathy, whatever word that might be used. Basically, you've got pain in your Achilles and we need to settle it down and get you back doing the things that you love. So why do Achilles become inflamed or becoming painful? Most commonly, it can be a sudden increase of load onto the tendon, more than what it's capable of. Typically, our capability of our tendon is just below our typical day-to-day activity. So if you're a runner, the capacity of what that tendon can do will always just stay above it. So if you suddenly increase the mileage maybe that you're doing, or the hills, you might be a runner, but whatever activity or whatever it is that you're doing, even just walking, and it's not used to that load and it hasn't had a chance to keep up, that can trigger inflammation or trigger pain into the heel. Your foot position plays a part in it, so it's good to see a physiotherapist and get that checked if you haven't already. You might need insoles or some kind of orthotics to help with that. And the other thing, maybe an injury, you might have, for an example, a footballer who suddenly changed direction and just overstretched and compressed the tendon, maybe onto that heel bone, or pulled the calf muscle, that may be triggering some potentially inflammation down into the heel. So, what can we do and what do we not want to do? So, tendons themselves, they like to be loaded, but the key thing about this is knowing the right type of loading and when to do it. We don't necessarily rest it completely. Like I mentioned earlier, the capacity of the tendon always just stays above what you're needing it for. So if you rest and don't do anything, the capacity of what the tendon can do will also drop as well. So as the pain settles down and you want to get back running again, you won't just get back to doing what you were before because the capacity of the tendon, it can't keep up. So you want to keep loading and keep strengthening the tendon, but we need to do it in a specific way. Typically, we want to load the tendon, but either isometrically or just statically to start off with, so we're not getting too much movement into the tendon, just loading it to keep that strength into it. Then we start to build up with gentle movement, and then moving on from there, so the pain settling down, rehabbing it in terms of getting some more kind of springy motions and explosive motions back into the tendon. But we need to go through this steady one at a time, depending on what your goals are, depending where you were, what we need to get you back to. Everybody will be different, which is why it's advised to get guidance from a physiotherapist. But I'm going to show you some simple exercises and typical exercises to help you at home. To know whether how much you're doing and whether it's the right type of exercise for you and when you're ready for that, what we need to feel for is kind of what pain you feel around in the tendon. Not necessarily when you're doing the exercise, but it's the day afterwards. So on that classic kind of visual analog scale of your pain from 0 to 10, 10 being the worst pain ever, the next day you should feel somewhere anywhere between a 2 and a 5 out of 10 is fine. Anything more than that, you've done a little bit too much, so we need to cut it back again. If you're not feeling anything at all, then we need to increase the load into the tendon. So that's a bit of a guide of what you should be feeling when you're rehabbing your tendon.